All right, guys, this video is to talk about GameStop. I'm out here roofing right now, and I can't help but think about everything going on with GameStop right now. And I mean, I'm very active in following the news, whether it's the underground subreddits or whether it's the YouTube channels or whether it's the mainstream news. I listen to it all, I dissect all the information, and I just want to know what's happening. And obviously, I mean, the main thing, I'm always looking for signs to see when it's going to happen, because something is happening right now. And I want to tell you guys all about it. So basically, the way that it all started is kind of, I guess, unique and why it worked. It was like a real, like, just underground movement of somebody saying he's going to bet his whole life savings on GameStop. And a whole bunch of people just saying, you know what, this is awesome. I'm going to back him. Let's see if we can help him win. And it started out that way. And then all of a sudden, the stock just took off. And when it did that, everyone's like, wow, look at this. We did something amazing. And then everyone, all the experts come out and talk about a short squeeze. But then they move right on to the next company. And so the next company that they targeted like that to say, like, you know what, this is the people's voice, this is the people's money, and we're all in on this together, and we're going to make this company super great too. Well, that company happened to be AMC. And so the first day that they really targeted the company, and it may not have been the first day, maybe the week after they really started putting in volume, it just popped. And so GameStop goes up 200% one day, AMC up 150% the same day. And that's when the Robinhood and other brokerages started limiting trading and only allowing you to sell, not allowing you to buy. And then the week after that, which is when I got in for about 100 grand, and I'm in about 5 different stocks. So the ones that I've seen where people are talking about, people put the volume in, and I believe that people are going to hold, and the holding is what makes all this valuable, is AMC, GameStop, Nokia, Naked, and Genius, which is G-N-U-S. And the Genius one doesn't have a ton of volume yet. The other four that I just named, a ton of volume. But the Genius one, that may be the one that after this all happens on the four companies, then we come in undercover and you guys help me do that last one. Just because the options are so valuable there right now. And so basically, you can turn a very small amount of money into a lot of money if you pop it and you drive it and you keep going the second that it happens. And so let's go ahead and talk about what happened. So GameStop got all this volume, right? And so normally what happens in a short squeeze or in any type of investment opportunity, really, whether it's Bitcoin or anything else, people will invest and they'll put their money in and they'll hold it. And then they'll hold it and hold it and hold it. And then eventually the rest of the world hears about it and they start investing, and that's what spikes the price. Well, what tends to happen right there is when this price gets spiked, the people start to sell for a profit. And so once you've sold for a profit, now you're helping drive the price back down. And ultimately, when you watch GameStop, when you watch these people, the people that are investing into this, the movement behind it, this isn't about GameStop. This isn't about a business. This isn't even about investing. What this is about the people coming together in one spot, in one currency, one asset allocation, and saying, we are putting all of our money here in spite of the government, in spite of the politics, in spite of the hedge funds, in spite of everything going on in this country that the average person is just fed up with. I mean, whether you're fed up with Biden, whether you're fed up with the right versus the left, whether you're fed up with the rich getting richer and the whole COVID and the lockdowns, everything, if you're fed up with how they're trying to alienate the Trump supporters and the Republicans, and you're just fed up with all of it, there's only one movement that is actually putting their money where their mouth is, and they're not selling, and they're holding until they make a serious profit. And the effects of this are going to be world-changing. And so if you want to be part of a movement, if you want to help initiate change, I mean, we're already here. There's probably 10 to 50 million of us worldwide that have invested in GameStop, whether it's one share or more. But the cool thing about this is that 10 million people, I mean, basically, if we, like the GameStop stock, most people got in above $100, and a lot of people only have one stock. But if you have all 10 million people with $100 shares of GameStop stock, that's $1 billion right there people put in. And what I'm getting at is everyone has $100. And so by coming together as 10 million people, we just proved that we can raise $1 billion a day, any day that we want to, because we have a people that are connected. And I mean, obviously there's gotta be a voice around it. They gotta be listening to one person if it was gonna happen as the way I just said it. But ultimately the effect, so there's multiple things that drive the price up of something. So like GameStop, right? There's the business, there's the fundamentals, there's how much profit are they making, all of that can help for sure. But what's happening right now is people are using it as a currency as if it was Bitcoin and saying, let's start from zero with this currency. And because there's a lot more Bitcoin than there is shares of GameStop. And so, like, if you just think about how much volume goes into GameStop, it's going to drive up the price because the shares, like, they're it's at its bottom dollar. And so now they're just so cash heavy. If they got as much cash that's sitting in their bank as much as maybe Apple does. And so that's why it's worth so much. The CEOs are rich. They're bringing on new employees, all this other stuff, because they just got more money than they know what to do with. And so they're blessed. They're fortunate. Do they deserve it? Maybe, maybe not. But that doesn't matter, because what's happening is a good thing and it's good for everybody. And so let's go on to the short version of this. So if you watch the news, if you go to the YouTube videos, everyone on the face of the earth right now is telling you that this only happened because people were shorting the stock 140% and yada yada, there's more shares and that just caused some type of apocalypse doomsday thing to happen. That's totally false. First off, most options are shorted heavily because a lot of people are playing with options, and options are just so cheap, and they collect so many contracts that basically every company has more shares out there than what is actually on their books. And it's because so many people are playing in options. But they're trying to confuse you, and they're trying to make you feel like the opportunity is gone and that it's too late to get in and it's too late to make money. It couldn't be more far from the truth. So their argument, the reason why it's too late, is because they're saying that the short interest is gone and that the big guys, they moved their money and they're no longer shorting the stock, and they're only doing this to, and so basically in order for us to win again, we'd have to go find out where they put their money. Well, none of that's true. Nobody chooses where they short. If you're part of the shorts, then you're just kind of hooked up to this computer that shorts the whole system, because at any market price, of any strike price, of any option in the whole stock market, we're talking about millions if not billions of different options that you could choose from, they are always access to it. So if you do a market order, it will get filled automatically. And it's not because somebody saw it and said, "Ooh, I want that order and I'm going to short it." It's because they're always shorting all of the market. And anytime you buy an option, that you're going basically against the machine that is always shorting the options. And so the whole government's set up to where they're shorting the market constantly. But really, they never short anything until somebody comes in and buys an option. So the buying of the option is actually what creates the short. And a lot of people don't understand that. And so what I'm getting at is that, sure, when the spike price, when the price spikes and the people shorting the stock have to come back and buy the stock, and that's going to make the price go up again. And so there is some extent to that as why the shorts are helping the price go up. But it doesn't matter what commodity in the world you're talking about. If 10 million people come together and they all put in $1,000 into anything in this world, it will be worth an insane amount of money, because 10 million people can change everything about this world. Like, 10 million people coming together is stronger than any other group or organization or individual or company or government or anything in this world. 10 million people with $1,000 all come together in the same spot, and it's game over. And that's what's happening right now. And so if you don't know if you want to be part of the GameStop thing or the, so again, GameStop, AMC, Nokia, and Naked, those four companies are all guaranteed winners. Throw in as much as you can, diversify between the four. Maybe take out, like, if you got $10,000, then put in $1,000 every day until it happens. And if it comes down, then every time you put in the next $1,000, then your price, you're getting a better You're doing like a cost per contract where you're lowering your cost to get in. But even just $1,000 into any of these four stocks, and it's going to make you a fortune, because people are putting tens of billions of dollars into these four companies, and it's going to drive the price up. And right now they're trying to tell you that it's too late, it's already happened, that the short interest is gone, but it had nothing to do with the short interest. That only amplified the effect. But these prices are going sky high. And since I've been in last week, I've been watching the prices constantly daily, and I've seen them turn off the market four times when GameStop has gone up 12% in, let's say, 5 to 10 seconds, just rallied like crazy. They turn it off and they say no more trading. And I'm on E-Trade, so I didn't have to deal with the Robinhood stuff, but this was after that. They keep turning it off every time it gets a crazy rally, and it's because they're not ready for the truth to be exposed yet. And so if you watch the news closely, you'll hear them talking about the crash that's coming, and they know it's coming because they saw the GameStop thing happen, and they know that the GameStop going through the roof like this is gonna cause inflation and all these other little problems, and it's gonna make all uncertainty for the rest of the companies and all the other stocks, and they're gonna start falling, and people are gonna start selling, and more people are gonna buy GameStop, Nokia, AMC, and they're gonna become the new versions of currency. And so you need to get on board as much as you can afford. I mean, I'm telling you, bet the farm. Like, this is bet everything you got, because this is a winner, the people coming together. I mean, it's a bunch of video game nerds that started it, but now this is a patriotic movement and everyone needs to be involved. And so if you're not involved yet, and you're hesitant and you didn't really know why, like, ask me questions. I can answer anything. I mean, I've been following the stock market for 2 years, and I don't mean following, I mean researching 16 hours a day every day. I've lost $500,000 in the stock market. Like, this is nothing to me. This is like, I was gonna be a billionaire in 2 years because I got this whole credit spread situation that can never lose, and I'm probably a couple months away from it actually being traded online. But then God brings this whole movement into my universe, and it may make it to where I make so much money, like, the stock market doesn't even matter anymore. And so I'm trying to rally the troops. I'm trying to rally the people. Trust me, GameStop, Nokia, AMC, Naked, they're going through the roof. I'm basically invested in like a bunch of different companies that I think are going to go through the roof because they got $5, $10 billion volume in the last 20 days. And all the other big companies, all the top 100 of the S&P 500 got no volume. I mean, the biggest one is Apple, and they got 100 million average per. So they got a billion in the last 20 days, let's just say, where all the other companies that you could possibly name, they got less than 100 million. And these other companies that I just named got 10 billions. So it's wild. It's exciting. It's time to get involved. If you're a Trump supporter and you were all about saving America and saving your freedom of speech and saving everything, this is how you do it. Put your money where your mouth is. This is the war. This is where it stops. This is it. And so read the book of Revelation. When they talk about the people coming together, when they talk about 144,000 people, like, those are the people that bought the GameStop and never held or never sold. So when my other stocks jump up because they're so low, lower than GameStop, when they're equal to or more than GameStop, I'm gonna sell those contracts, convert them into GameStop. Overall, I believe GameStop's going all the way, and I don't think it'll ever come down. I think it is the new standard of the people's voice and opinion, and why you buy something is more important than how much you put into it. And so even though someone else has $1 trillion, when we put in 10 billion and then the government comes and shuts us down and then we throw in another 10 billion, that's why it's worth more than anything else, is because we are standing up with our mouths, with our money, with our voice, with our people, numbers, large numbers, and it's unstoppable. It's unstoppable. And so anyone telling you that this is a scam or that the short's already been squoze, it's got nothing to do with that. It's going up either way. And so right now they're suppressing the stocks. I guarantee you they are suppressing the stocks. They're bringing them down, because when GameStop was at 450 and they stopped the trading and they brought it all the way down to $50, all the options that were expiring before they brought it down, they probably saved themselves $1 trillion. And so now they're putting that risk on somebody else. And as soon as the risk is transferred and the people that are in charge no longer got to pay that $1 trillion, they're going to let somebody else lose it. And so anyone that's got their money in 401ks probably going to say goodbye to their money. But unless you sell out and go and buy GameStop and AMC, that's the only way. Yeah, well, I hope you guys see what I see. If you have any questions, I'm happy to answer them. But basically, I haven't seen anyone have a real opinion like this on it. And so, again, let's talk about that. When GameStop is shorted 140%, that means the retail investors are buying options at 140%. So it's not like, the retail is being just as greedy as the shorters. Like there's no boogeyman, there's no bad guy, but the real driving factor behind all of this is the people coming together, putting all their money. And then when the short squeeze happens, it actually forces these rich people to buy the same stock as you at a crazy high price. And so the more that they gotta buy, eventually their mindset's gonna change and say, we can't stop GameStop. And so we gotta drive the price so high that everybody sells and we're the only one left. And then they can just basically transform that currency into a new government system. But I am never selling my shares. GameStop to the moon, and I will own the bloody freaking moon. Buy GameStop, guys.